Our lecture today is of general principles of organization and classification of the tissues. Epithelial tissues or epithelia. What is a tissue? Tissue is a system of the body that is formed in the process of phylogenesis and consists of cells and their derivatives. United by common origin and the structure and the function. Next name is a very important meaning. It's the histogenesis. Histogenesis is the development of tissues from embryonic sources. And histological elements. What does it mean? Tissue forming units. Like cells, synplast, syncytia, intercellular substance, or tissue
matrix.
Let's tell about each element of the tissue one by one. Cells. What is it? Cells. They are main element of all tissues, which are determining their basic properties. If you remember from the first lesson of histology, cells is like elementary biological system. It is composed by three main elements. Nucleus, cytolemma, and the cytoplasm. Except cell, which components, which structures or unit can compose tissue? It's a postcellular structure. Postcellular structure, there are tissue forming units which we cannot call cells because of absence of some parts like nucleus or element of the cytoplasm. There are elements within the first part of the lifetime where they are real cells, but during differentiation, during development, they lose some element of them. Like nucleus or organelles, and finally became structures which we couldn't call cells, but we can call them postcellular structures. Post from Latin language, it means after. So being cells, and they have all of elements of the cells, all exhibition of cells, and all properties of cells, and during development, during their lifetime, something happened with them. They became structures which are post-cellular structures. What about example? For example, platelets, erythrocytes, or keratin plates, all of them are post-cellular structures. Next element, next tissue-forming unit, it's a simplest. Simplest, there are structures which are not cell because they don't contain and don't contain enough amount of the cell membrane. They contain a lot of they can contain a lot of organelles, a lot of cytoplasm, but less amount of the cytolemma if it's necessary. How it's necessary for the cell. Which example of such type? Tissue forming unit is a simplest. It's for example, trophoblast, muscle fibers. There are tissue forming units of the skeletal muscle. Next element, a possible element for formation of the tissue is a syncytium. There are structures which organize as a result in complete mitotic division. It looks like a lot of cells which are not separated and they are connected from each other and they are connected by cytoplasmic branches. If some type cells during the mitotic division don't finish this mitotic division and they stop this mitotic division before telophase, so we can get syncytium. What about example? It's a example. For example, it's a spermatogenic epithelium, and for example, syncytial trophoblast. Or what about extra intercellular substance? Intercellular substance is a tissue forming unit of the tissue, which is located between main structures, which are cells, symplast, syncytia. Intercellular substance is a compound structure. It's usually composed by two main parts. It's like fluid part, non-fluid part. It's a ground substance and fiber structure. Each general meaning is a general principle of the structure. But each type of tissue has its own properties, has its own characteristics and morphological exhibitions, and we will tell about each of them particularly. During lifetime, each type of cell undergoes differentiation. Differentiation is a process during which cells of the tissue pass number of stages of development, gradually getting structural and functional properties of mature element. And during differentiation, each type of tissue creates its own differon. Differon is set of all cells making the given line of differentiation. From the less differentiated stem up to the most mature differentiated. Many tissues contain several cellular differons which cooperate with each other. So each type of tissue contains differon. Differon is a set of cells, since stem cells till mature cell. Look here, so stem cell, it's a less differentiated. It's the youngest, but it's a mother cell, and it has a light nucleus and a small amount of the cytoplasm. It's undifferentiated. Undeterminated young cell, which can live in the G0 period of the cell life cycle, but it can divide by mitosis only one time. After mitotic division of the stem cell, appear two type cells. First one is a stem cell renewal, which take place mother cells we divided by mitosis, and other second type cells which undergo differentiation and get new functional and morphological properties to become mature cell. Only mature cells can make function of tissues which it composed. Actually, our organism is composed by four main type tissues. There are connective tissue, epithelial tissue, muscle tissue, nervous tissue. And each type tissue present each own different. In each type tissue can be present fixed cells, which are aborigine cells, all this type tissue, and free cells, which come here from other type tissue to help main cells to do their functions. Muscle tissue and nervous tissue, they are highly specialized tissue because they have a special functions. Muscle tissue can have ability for contraction, and because the structural units of muscle tissue contain special organelles, which are myofibrils, and nervous tissue have ability for conduction of neuroimpulse, and also cells of the nervous tissue contain special organelles, which are, for example, neurofibrils. And connective tissue and epithelial tissue, they are less specialized, and they have ability for regeneration, highly regenerative tissue, connective tissue, and epithelial. So epithelial tissues. This is a table is about classification of tissues by one lady, and all of tissues can be divided to general and special. Special, the muscular tissue, muscle tissue, and nervous tissue, and general epithelial, and tissues the inside amount or group of connective tissue. Epithelial tissues are widespread throughout the body. They form the covering of all body surfaces, line body cavities, and hollow organs. enzymomedial tissue in glands. What are functions of epithelium? The first one, protection. Epithelia protects underlying tissues from mechanical injury. Next one, absorption. Certain epithelial cells lining the intestine absorb nutrients from the digestion of food. Third, secretion. In glands, epithelial tissue is specialized to secrete specific chemical substances such as enzymes, hormones, and lubrication fluids. Fourth function, excretion. Epithelial tissues in the kidney excrete waste products from the body and reabsorb need materials from the urina. Sweat is also excreted from the body by epithelial cells in the sweat glands. Fifth, sensation. Sensory stimuli are detected by specialized epithelial cells. Specialized epithelial tissue containing sensory nerve endings is found in the skin, ears, eyes, and nose, and in the tongue. Sixth, diffusion. Simple epithelium promotes the diffusion of gases, liquids, and nutrients. Because they form such thin layers, they are ideal for the diffusion of gas. The example of such type epithelial wall of capillaries and alveolar lungs. Seventh, contraction. Some type epithelial cells, which are named myoepithelial cells, have ability to contract. Eight, cleaning. Ciliated epithelium assists to removing different particles and foreign bodies which have entered the air passages. And let's go to general morphological sense of epithelial tissues. And the first, cells in epithelial tissue are closely packed together. And the next, intercellular substance is reduced to a minimum. As you see on this picture, intercellular substance is composed by the ground substance only, fibers absent. And the spaces between neighboring cells so thin that intercellular substance is a small amount, very, very small amount. A neck characteristic, all of cells rest on basal lamina. The next, polarity of epithelial cells. And each epithelial cell can be divided to two levels or two parts. It's the apical part and basic part. Basic part of the cytolemma and basic part of the cytoplasm. And epithelial cells, as usual, and the basic part take place nucleus and synthetic organelles. And the apical part, if it's a secretion cells, present granules with secretory granules, and they take apical part. It's easier to release these substances through the free apical part if they are located here. Talking about polarity of the cytolemma, you must remember that apical part of the cytolemma contain vaginations like microvilli, cilia, and basic part doesn't contain any microvilli and cilia, but sometimes basic part of the cytolemma make vaginations between them, take place mitochondria, and we can call such type pattern in the basic part of the epithelial cells as basal striation. All epithelia have a blood that doesn't have blood vessels. It's a vascular tissue. But epithelia need nutrients. Where from they get them? They get the nutrients from underlying connective tissue which contain blood vessels by draining these nutrients through the basement membrane. And the next properties of epithelial tissue is availability of intercellular junctions between lateral surfaces of neighboring cells present intercellular junctions, all of type present here. Also present in the junction between basic part of the cytolemma and the basement membrane. And the next, high ability to regeneration. And what about basal lamina and basement membrane? The basal lamina connects the epithelium and subjacent connective tissue. Here you can see underlying connective tissue, which is a loose connective tissue. And it contains a lot of blood vessels and nerve endings. And these epithelial tissue and this connective tissue is separated by the basement membrane. So let's start from the basal lamina. With electron microscope, the basal lamina consists of two layers. Inner lamina lucida, seen a morphous layer, a cellular structure, which is composed by the glycoproteins. And outer lamina densa, thick network of collagen fibers. Outside the basal lamina associated with the reticular lamina, which consists of delicate reticular fibers. The combination of basal lamina and the layer of reticular fibers appear as a single membrane under the optical microscope termed the basement membrane. So basement membrane is composed by the basal lamina and reticular lamina, and basal lamina is composed by the lamina lucida and lamina densa. Classification of epithelia. As the first, epithelia can be divided by the function to covering and glandular epithelia. The next classification is a histogenetic classification of epithelia. A histogenetic classification is a classification depending on the origin. The epithelium develops from all three embryonic layers. So, depending on the embryonic source, we have next type of epithelium. Epidermal type, which origins from the embryo of the ectoderm, and the examples of such type epithelium, it's the epidermis of the skin, epithelium of the nasal cavity, mouth cavity, anal canal, and the cornea. The next type epithelium, it's a endodermal, origin from the endoderm. Such type epithelium epithelium of the alimentary system and respiratory system, there are endodermal epithelium. It's a lining epithelium of the digestive tube and the respiratory system. Third type is a cellonephrodermal, as origin from the cellomic space and from the nephrotome. It's the mesoderm, intermediate mesoderm. What about location of such type epithelium in the human body? In a nephron, it's in genital ducts, in ovary, testes, prostate glands, renal cortex, and mesothelium. Next type, angiodermal. Angiodermal originates from the mesenchyme, and location in the it's a lining epithelium of blood of vessels. It has a special name, endothelium. And last type, ependymoglial. Origin from the neuroectoderm, and location in the human body, it's the ependymal cells that line the cavities of the CNS. The next type of classifications of the epithelial tissue is a morphofunctional classification of epithelia. Epithelia are classified according to the structure and the function into two main groups, covering integumentary epithelia and glandular epithelia. Covering is epithelia, there are tissues whose cells organize into the layers that cover the external surface or line the cavities of the body. Covering epithelia are classified according to the number of cells layers and morphology of cells in the surface layers. Can be classified to the simple epithelia, which consists only of one layer of cells, and stratified epithelia contain more than one layer Also, epithelia can be classified depending on the shape of cells, to the squamous, cuboidal, columnal. There are four types of simple epithelia. It's a simple squamous epithelium, simple cuboidal epithelium, simple columnal epithelium, and the pseudostratified columnal ciliated epithelium. Let's start from the simple squamous epithelium, which composed of flattened and irregularly shaped cells. It's found in the alveoli of lungs, parietal layer of Bowman's capsule, in the distant limb of the headless loop, in blood and lymph vessels, in serous cavities. Pay attention that the lung epithelium of blood and lymph vessels has a special name. Simple squamous epithelium of blood and lymph vessels is named endothelium. And the lining epithelium of serous cavities also has special name. It is the name mesothelium. Next type, simple cuboidal epithelium, consists of one layer of cuboidal cells. It's found in follicles of thyroid glands, proximal and distal convoluted tubules, respiratory bronchioles, composed pigment layer of retina, geminal epithelium of ovary, ducts of many glands. Next type, it's a simple columnal epithelium, consists of one layer of columnal-shaped cells. It's found in the stomach, small intestine, most of large intestine, ducts of pancreas and gallbladder, oviduct. Next, very interesting type, it's a pseudostratified columnal ciliated epithelium, the forename. As the name of such type of epithelium is a respiratory epithelium. It's a true simple epithelium because all cells lie on the basal lamina. Every cell of this epithelium is connected with basal lamina, but cells are of various type, tall and short. Nucleus of cells are located on different levels, so it looks like stratified, but really it's simple. And the free surfaces of tall cells have cilia, so we call it ciliated. It's found in trachea and bronchi and nasopharynx. And let me remind that it's as a name of such type of epithelium, it's a respiratory epithelium because of location in the respiratory system. Also, we have three types of stratified epithelia. It's a stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelia, stratified squamous keratinized epithelia, and transitional epithelium or urothelium. The stratified squamous non-keratinized epithelium consists of three layers. Stratum basale contain a single layer of columnal or cuboidal cells resting on the basal lamina. So that we call it stratum basale because of connecting with basal lamina. Next, stratum spinosum. Stratum spinosum consists of polygonal cells, and the cells of this stratum have long processes which connected with the basal lamina. And so that the cells of this stratum got name from the shape of cells. And the last layer, the surface layer, consists of squamous cells. Where is located such type of epithelium? In the mouth of the oral cavity and the esophagus, cornea, and in the vagina. The next type is stratified squamous keratinized epithelium. Consists of five layers of keratin production cells or keratinocytes. So that it got name keratinized. It's composed by five layers. It's a stratum basale. Also, it's take place in formation of stratum geminatium together with next layer, which is a stratum spinosum. Stratum basale consists of single layer of basophilic columnal or cuboidal cells resting on the basal lamina. Within cells present a lot of stem cells. with give regeneration. They may have regeneration for keratinocyte of upper layers. Next one, stratum spinosum, which consists of polygonal cells with a central nucleus and cytoplasm whose processes are filled with bundles or filaments. As they together, stratum spinosum and stratum basale create stratum germinativum. Next stratum, stratum granulosum, is characterized by three or five layers of flattened polygonal cells with the cytoplasm filled with basophilic granules called keratohyaline granules. So it's the cells of stratum granulosum have a function, new function. They start production of keratohyaline. Next stratum, stratum lacidum, the thin layer of flattened eosinophilic cells, contain droplets of elaidin. So they have a new, very potent function. They start production of elaidin and accumulate it in the cytoplasm. And upper layer, it's a stratum corollum that consists of 15 to 20 layers of flattened plates or dead cells which contain all keratin. And this stratum can be divided to two levels, upper layer and lower level. Lower levels basically is composed by mature keratinocyte with during differentiation loss of organelles and nucleus and cumulate granules of keratin, and finally they became post cellular structures which are keratin plate. And what about location of such type epithelium? We can find it in the epidermis of the skin. It's lining epithelium of the surface of the human body. Let's go to the transitional epithelium. It's a highly specialized epithelium. It's found only in the urinary tract. Cells are arranged in 3 to 5 layers. In the relaxed state of their organ, the surface cells are large, rounded. In the street, surface cells became flattened. So it's a stratified epithelium, but we cannot describe the shape of cells because it's very close to the condition of the organ. If it's fallen empty, shape of cells can be cuboidal. Columnal, and location urinary tract from the pelvis of the kidney to the beginning of the urethra. So it has a special name or its own name. It's a urothelium. Glandular epithelium. The cells of glandular epithelia are specialized to produce the fluid secretion. Glands are classified according to the mechanism of secretion. Exocrine gland secretes the viaduct into the apical or epithelial surface. Endocrine glands release the secretion directly into blood or lymph vessels. These glands have no ducts, but they have a greatly developed blood supply. Paracrine glands, they are similar to endocrine glands, but secretion reaches target cells by diffusion through the extracellular space to neighboring cells. Morphology of secretory cycle. Process of secretion in gland cells proceeds cyclically and includes four phases. The first phase of absorption of initial substances for synthesis of secretion come from blood through the plasmolina of basal polar of the glandular cell. So cells get different substances by draining through the basal lamina from underlying blood vessels which take place in the connective tissue. The next phase of synthesis of a secretion. Process of transcription and translation in rough endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi complex for protein secretion and smooth endoplasmic reticulum for steroid substances. Third phase of accumulation of the synthesized products, increase of the maintenance of secretory granules and the accumulation of secretory granules in cytoplasm in the apical part of the cell if it's an exocrine cells and in the basic part of the cell if it's an endocrine cells. And the last phase, fourth phase of extraction of and secretion. Exocytosis of content of secretory granules. So releasing content of secretory granules by the exocytosis. Exocrine glands consist of two parts. First part is the secretory portion, which contains the cells responsible for secretory process. And second part, there is a duct system which transports the secretion to the exterior of the glands. Exocrine glands are classified based on six different morphological criteria. First, classification depends on the number of secretory cells, unicellular glands and multicellular glands. Exocrine glands are classified based on the six different morphological criteria. Depend on the number of secretory cells, unicellular glands and multicellular glands. Unicellular glands or goblet cells are mucus secreting cells. They are found in the epithelium of the trachea, bronchi, small and large intestine. And multicellular glands consist of many cells. The next classification, the according to the location of secretory cells relation to the epithelium. Intraepithelial glands, there are goblet cells and they're located inside. And the extraepithelial inside in the epithelium within epithelial cells. And extraepithelial glands, they are all large exocrine glands. The third classification is dependent on the niche of secretion. Mucus glands contains mucus secreting cells, for example, lingual glands. Next type, serous glands. The secretory portion contains only serous cells, for example, parotid glands, pancreas, and mixed glands, serous and mucus. The secretory portions contain both mucus and serous cells, and the secretion is mixed. For example, submandibular, sublingual, salivary glands. The fourth type of classification is depend on the mechanism of secretion. It depends on the mechanism of secretion, it's a mirocrine. No part of cell is lost, only the secretory product is expelled by the process of exocytosis. It is the most common mode of secretion and is seen in serous, mucus, and mixed glands. The example of such type glands is the sweat glands. Next type, apocrine. Part of apical cytoplasm of the cell is lost. Secretion is discarded within free and the membrane-bound vesicles. Such type glands as apocrine, sweat glands, and mammary glands. So during secretion, cell loss don't apical part of the cell together with apical part of the cell membrane and secretory vesicles. So type the holocrine. The anterior secretory cells is lost. The example of such type glands, sebaceous glands. So the after secretion, cells died. Next type classification, fifth type. It's depend on the shape of secretory portions. Tubular, acina, and tubulo acino glands. Tubulo glands in an elongated group of secretory cells with Roman shaped like a tube. Acina or alveola, sac-like group of secretory cells arranged about a small lamin. And tubular acina, lamina secretory units has both of the above stated shapes. So, a tubular shape secretory portions and alveola present together. And the sixth type classification arrangement, branched or not, of duct system. Simple glands. Glands of this type have an unbranched duct into which the cells secrete. Each secretory portion empties separately on an epithelial surface. Branched glands. Several secretory units empty into an unbranched excretory duct. And compound glands. These glands have a highly branched duct system. Secretory portion empty into an elaborate branched duct system, which is turned draining to the larger ducts.